Hello everyone, so today we're going to go over section 3.3, estimating square roots. In order to estimate square roots, it is good to know square roots of perfect squares. So we're going to look at a few of these right now. So you should know that the square root of 36 is 6, square root of 81 is 9, and the square root of 169 is 13. So up to 15 is the ones that you want to know. So from 1, 4, 9, and so forth, all the way up to 225. Now, if you're given an unfamiliar number and you want to determine if it is a perfect square or not, we use prime factorization. So let's look at the prime factorization of 196 and also 220. So in the case of 196, we can divide by 2, and we have 98, which is even, so we can divide by 2 again. And then we're left with 49, which we know is 7 squared, so 7 times 7. Which means the prime factorization of 196 is going to be 2 times 2 times 7 times 7. Alright, likewise for 220, we can divide by 2, so we get 110. We can divide by 2 again, because 110 is even, we are left with 55. And of course, if that's divisible by 5, and we're left with 11. So 220 is equal to 2 times 2 times 5 times 11. So what we talked about last day is that for a number to be a perfect square, it needs to have an even number of each prime factor. So if you look at these two numbers above, 196 would be the perfect square. That is an even number of each prime factor. Okay, 2 2s and 2 7s to be specific. Because now we can put those into two equal groups, so 2 times 7 times 2 times 7. And we can see that 196 is equal to 14 times 14, or 14 squared. Okay. Now, what if we're given square numbers or perfect squares that are not, what if we're looking for square roots of numbers that are not perfect squares? Then we have to estimate. Now, of course, you can use a calculator for this, but if without a calculator, this is kind of a nice process of doing so. So we're looking at a few examples right now. Let's start with the square root of 10. So we know that square root of 10 is very close to the square root of 9, which is just below it. And the next number above that is going to be 16. It's the next closest perfect square. Which means that if we take the square root of the perfect squares, then the square root of 10 is somewhere between 3 and 4. Now, if we look at how far 10 is from each number, we can see that it's 1 away from 9 and 6 away from 16. So if we were to estimate the square root of 10 as being somewhere between 2 and 3, it's going to be closer to 3. So a reasonable estimate would be that the square root of 10 is close to 3.2. So this, of course, here means that approximately equal to, because we estimated. Same thing, let's look at a few more of these. We're looking at the square root of 62. And the closest perfect square is probably 64, which is just above. And below that, we have 7 squared, which is 49. So that places the square root of 62 somewhere between 7 and 8. And in this case, it is 13 away from 49, but only 2 away from 8. So it's going to be fairly close to 8. Which makes a reasonable estimate something around, let's say, maybe 7.8. Okay. couple more here. We have 39. So if we're looking at the square root of 39, then the closest perfect square is probably 36. And then the next one up is going to be 49. So the square root of 39 is somewhere between 6 and 7. And then we look at how far it is from each number. It's 3 away from 36 and 10 away from 49. So it's probably closer to 6. So we're using that. We can say that the square root of 39 is approximately 6.2, maybe 6.3. Finally, last one here, we have 110. So the closest perfect squares are 100 and 121, which places the square root of 110 somewhere between 10 and 11. And this one, sorry about that. This is 100. So it's 10 away from 100 and 11 away from 121. So the square root is probably somewhere in the middle. So a reasonable estimate would be that the square root of 110 is 10.5. Okay, so from there, it's a quick word problem. Felicity wants to know if a wading pool will fit in a small space in her yard. The area is 7 square meters. And we want to find the side length, which of course is it's a square pool. So we're looking for the square root of 7. And we're going to estimate that because we know 7 is not a perfect square. So we have the square root of 7, which is just less than the square root of 9. But it is greater than the square root of 4. So it's going to be somewhere between 2 and 3. And it's 3 away from 4 and 2 away from 9. So in this case, a reasonable estimate would probably be like 2.6. Meters, so. Okay, so. And of course, if you use a calculator to find the value, you will see that it is approximately equal to 2.6. 4575, and the number does not terminate nor repeat, so I'm just going to write down a few decimal places and that will be sufficient. So yeah, it is going to be an approximate answer. Okay, so we can also ask the same question but almost backwards. So it says here, what is a whole number that has a square root between 2 and 3? So what we're going to do is we're going to introduce a variable x, which is going to be some whole number. Now we have 2, which is less than the square root of x, which is less than 3, which satisfies the condition x is a whole number and has a square root that's between 2 and 3. Now what we can do is rewrite this as square root of 4 is less than the square root of x, which is less than the square root of 9. So we know, based on this, that 4 is less than x is less than 9. So x could be any number, any whole number, that's between 4 and 9. So x could be 5, 6, 7, or 8. So that's kind of the process. Same kind of question we have. What if it was between 6 and 7? Well, same setup. 6 is less than the square root of x is less than the less than 7, so which means the square root of 36 is less than square root of x is less than the square root 49, which means x is somewhere between 36 and 49. Okay, so x is a whole number. Between 37 to 48 inclusive. So we're going to include 37, 48. Oops, inclusive. How many whole numbers are there? Well, we can simply subtract 48 minus 37. That's 11, but we're counting inclusively, so 11 plus 1 is equal to 12 whole numbers in total. And that's it. So that's a way to estimate square roots without using a calculator. You can always verify your answers if you have access to a calculator. And that's it for today. So thank you for listening.